Hello everyone, I'm Rhonda Divecha, an assistant professor of human development and psychology, and today I'm going to talk about staying positive during the pandemic. Staying positive during the pandemic, you'll say? This word positive has actually taken on a new connotation during this pandemic. It creates fear in people as we associate it with the COVID-19 medical report. This COVID-19 situation has brought in a new set of experiences. One major life change for most of us is staying home and having lockdowns and restrictions, some still managed initially. But then the further extensions and lockdowns have played havoc in some families. Each home and family is different, and there is no single formula that will work to keep us happy. But one thing that is commonly usable is the power to think positively. So the first thing is to shift the word positive from a medical report to a psychological frame of mind. All of us have this power to think positively. But you'll say, why do some people still act so negative then if all have the power? The difference is that some choose to exercise this power and some don't. It's just as simple as that. We have a choice to search for some benefit even from a hard-earned life's lesson, however bad it may seem currently. And mind you, this is not as difficult as some may feel. There's a simple rule. Ask yourself, whatever happens, this simple question. What is something I can learn through this? Or how can this be good for me or my family? Or any such similar question. And most importantly, after asking, search for the answer. You see, no one can give you this answer. It has to be found by you. Only then will you believe it, and only then will it make you feel good. Think of a time that something bad or sad has happened to you. You may have experienced someone coming and telling you it happened for a reason, or everything happens for the best. But you didn't feel that for yourself. It was because it was their perception, not yours. What I'm trying to say here is, for positive thinking to have a good effect on us, we have to own it. It has to be our own thoughts, or it won't make us feel good. You know, there was a time several years ago that my purse got stolen while I was shopping. It hassled me a lot as I kept saying it was my hard-earned money, and I was angry at the person who dishonestly took it. Then when I realized there was nothing I could do about it, and however angry I got, it wasn't coming back to me. I just chose to change my thoughts. I started saying, maybe that person needed the money more than I did. And gradually, I began to feel alright. I don't mean let go of something if it's stolen. If there's a way of you tracking it and getting it back, do so. My point here is, do you have control? Then exercise it. But there are some things that happen that we don't have control over. But we have control over our thoughts. We can choose to put in a little effort and turn bad thoughts into good thoughts. Let me explain that in another simple way. Even if you don't have sunglasses, you can still imagine this. It's a small exercise. Imagine you're looking through dark glasses. What's the result? Everything looks dark. I've got a couple of sunglasses here to illustrate this. Now imagine we are looking through purple glasses. What's the result? Everything looks purple. To me, not to you. So I'll have to hold it here for you to realize that. Okay? You can see me looking purple when you look through the purple glasses. Now imagine we're looking through rose-colored glasses. Okay, of course, you'll have to see me through the camera lens. So I'm putting it here. Okay, you can see me red in color through rose-colored glasses. This is probably where the proverb came, looking at the world through rose-colored glasses. Everything seems nice and rosy. But I'm sure you've got the drift by now. I don't mean red and purple. These are just symbols. We have to look at the world through positive lenses. We can choose to wear the bright positive lenses rather than the dark negative lenses when looking at things as we go through life, thereby actually seeing good. Let's use some examples from our everyday life, okay? Instead of saying, I'm stuck at home, try saying, I'm safe as I have a home. Instead of saying, I'm so bored at home, I've got nothing to do, try saying, I've got this time to do things that I would never have time to do before. Instead of saying, working from home is so time consuming, I'm working the whole day, try saying, I'm grateful that I'm employed. In fact, we can pause this video here and you can try some more little statements like this as your own little exercise. Think of things you have been saying lately that brought you down. Can you modify them and think positively? Now, if you've done that, the main effect of this whole new way of thinking is that you'll be a happier person. So try, pause the video, try those statements, change them, and then let's see if you feel like a happier person. Finally, if you're a beginner at this, and if you've just begun to actually start focusing on the positive, initially it may seem a bit artificial or kind of fake, but believe me, if you start doing it regularly, initially it will need a bit of effort, but it will gradually become a habit. Ignore those who make fun of you initially. Gradually, they will see the happier person you've become and they will follow in your footsteps, even though they may not admit it. An important thing to add, of course, before I end, is being positive doesn't mean never thinking negative thoughts, but to be realistic and change them if they are affecting us negatively. Don't think you're being over positive and say, nothing will happen to me if I don't wear a mask, or I can go out unnecessarily. That's not positive. That's being unrealistic. Follow safety protocols all the time and stay realistic. You know, there's a beautiful prayer of serenity that I'll end with. It has its origins from a theologian many years ago, and it has been used with the Alcoholics Anonymous, but it has a secular significance for any religion. It goes like this. God, grant me the serenity to accept the things I cannot change, the courage to change the things I can, and the wisdom to know the difference. So if we can't change certain things around us, let's accept them by thinking positively. Thank you and stay safe.